Guys!
Good morning. Good morning, I'm Morgan.
And I'm Makaya. Today's day is Friday, January 17, 2014.
It's the 95th day of school.
The weather today will be a high of 45 and a low with 20 to a partly cloudy skies.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the singing of the Star-Spangled Banner.
Next, we'll pause for a moment of silent reflection. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now to our interviewer, Paula.
And our special guest, Ms. DePue.
Good morning, Ms. DePue. Welcome to GVTV.
Good morning, Paula. Good morning, Green Valley.
Our lunch today is fish nuggets, hush puppies, turkey tetrazzini, grabwise ham, chef salad, baby parslide carrots, roasted Brussels sprouts, fresh strawberries, and applesauce.
Sounds like a good lunch for us today.
What do you want to talk to us about today?
Well, I have several things. First of all, we are collecting a great number of jackets down in our lost and found. And as cold as it has been in the mornings, I want to remind each class as you go to PE, please check and make sure that you are not one of our Gators that have lost their jacket. If you have, go ahead and get it and take it home. I'm sure your parents will be extremely excited that it came home with you. We also have a special guest with us today. This is Logan, and Logan has been selected for the State Superintendent's Art Show, and this is a really big honor. He did some artwork in Ms. Morgan's class. You want to tell everybody what your artwork was?
Sure.
What was it? Was it a tree?
I don't know what it was.
Okay, well, he was selected with his artwork, and he was chosen along with five other elementary students here in Hoover City Schools, and his artwork is going to be on display at the old Supreme Court Library at the State Capitol. So that's a huge honor. I believe they're going to, let's give him a round of applause. I believe they're going to keep it on display for a little while. It's been framed and matted so that everybody can see it, and that's a huge honor because only five from all of Hoover City Schools, all of our elementary schools, were chosen. So congratulations. Okay, we also have a wondrous word today. Will you show us our wondrous word?
Yearned.
Yearned. Today, our wondrous word is yearned. And it came to us from Daniela in Miss Giles' class, and that's third grade. And the book she was reading was a nonfiction book called Abe Lincoln. Now, the reason why I selected this particular wondrous word is because when I read it and looked at the paper, I realized that Daniela used a really good strategy in her reading. She came across this word yearned and did not know what it meant. So she went to the dictionary, looked it up, maybe on her Nook, maybe in a traditional dictionary, to find out what it actually meant. So the definition she gave us actually came from the definition in a dictionary. So the sentence was, "But all the while he worked, he yearned to learn." And she said that it meant to have a strong, melancholy desire for something. And when I looked it up in the dictionary, tell us what it meant.
Verb, have an intense feeling of longing for something, to have a strong, often melancholy desire.
Okay, so I knew she had actually looked that definition up. So good job, Daniela. Thank you for using a good reading strategy. And since it is Friday, let's let our lovely assistant choose a teacher for the teacher of the week. And of course, I won't share who that is. We will have to read the communicator. Ah, good job. Okay, we'll read the communicator to find out who that that deserving teacher is. That's all I have, y'all.
Thanks for visiting us on GVTV. Now back to our anchors, Morgan and Lakiah.
Have a great Gator Day. Bye.